Welcome to Suncoast. My trip to Krakow, Poland was a great deal of fun. I drove to Poland. I came from Prague, and the whole trip from the Czech Republic to Poland was absolutely wonderful. It was a very easy trip. It was on highways. Krakow is nestled in the southern part of Poland along the banks of the Vista River, which is the country's longest river. It's situated in a valley that's surrounded by gentle hills and not too far from the majestic Carpathian Mountains, which makes the city a perfect mix of urban charm and natural beauty. The city's layout is like a treasure map, with its heart being the historic old town surrounded by a park called Planty, where medieval city walls once stood. This central park is a UNESCO World Heritage Site and is home to many narrow cobblestone streets and charming squares. The weather when I was there was absolutely fantastic and sunny and beautiful. Krakow has a population of around 780,000 people, making it Poland's second largest city. It's a young and dynamic city with a large student population thanks to its many universities. Krakow is also a technology hub because of the presence of universities, a lot of young educated people, and well-developed skilled workforce. Krakow's history stretches back over 1,000 years. The city was settled in the 7th century and grew into a significant trading center due to its strategic location on the Vistula River. By 1038, Krakow became Poland's capital and remained the royal city for hundreds of years. Krakow, it's gone through many changes, wars, battles, communism, and of course now a member of the European Union. It's become a major tourist attraction because it truly is a beautiful city. Krakow's Jagiellonian University was founded in 1364 and is one of the oldest in Europe. People in Krakow are very proud of their cultural heritage, and they celebrate it through music, art, and traditions. And the city has a strong sense of community and is also welcoming to newcomers. The one thing that I found about Krakow is that it has a lot of legends. One of the most popular legends is the Wavell Dragon. According to the story, a fearsome dragon lived in a cave beneath Wavell Hill, terrorizing the local people by devouring livestock and threatening the city. Many knights tried to defeat the dragon, but all failed. A clever shoemaker named Skuba came up with a plan to trick the dragon. He stuffed a sheep with sulfur and placed it outside the dragon's cave. The dragon devoured the sheep and soon became unbearably thirsty due to the sulfur. It drank and drank from Vistula River until it exploded. The people of Krakow rejoiced and Skuba became a hero. Today, you can find a statue of the dragon near the Wavell Castle that breathes fire, delighting visitors. Now here's another legend. The legend of King Krakus. And every time I read this, I keep on thinking of Krakus ham, which was so popular in the United States back in the late 70s and early 80s. It was exported in large numbers. I assume that it was made in Krakow, and it has something to do with this name, King Krakus. Well, the city of Krakow is said to be named after its mythical founder, King Krakus, Krak. According to legend, King Krakus was a wise ruler who defeated the Wavell Dragon and built a city on the hill where the dragon's cave was located. After the dragon was defeated, King Krakus became a beloved leader and Krakow flourished under its reign. When he died, his people mourned deeply and built a large mound as his tomb, which is known as Krakus Mound. This mound still stands today and offers a panoramic view of the city. And here's my last legend, the two towers of St. Mary's Basilica. St. Mary's Basilica, with its two tall towers, is one of Krakow's most iconic landmarks. But why do the towers look different from each other? Well, the legend tells the story of two brothers who were commissioned to build the towers. The older brother was in charge of the taller northern tower, while the younger brother worked on a shorter southern tower. As the construction progressed, the younger brother realized that his tower was smaller and would never match up to his older sibling's tower. Overcome with jealousy, he murdered his brother with a knife so that he could finish his own tower without competition. When he later confessed to his crime, he was overwhelmed with guilt and threw himself from the tower to his death. Today, the towers still stand as they were, with the northern tower taller than the southern tower. Inside the basilica, the knife that is said to have been used in the crime is displayed as a reminder of the tragic tale. That sounds like an Abel and Cain kind of story. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.